Hello dear students, my name is Vidyasagar Giri and I belongs to Kushinagar itself. Currently I am a biology teacher in PSM Public School, which is located in New Delhi. Luckily, I got an opportunity to join St. Joseph School as a biology teacher, which I also do that because Kushinagar is my hometown and I think everyone is loved to live in their home, to live in their hometown. So if this critical condition, this pandemic situation getting over, we will meet soon our offline classes. But right now we are going to start it online mode. The very first chapter of your biology sections in your book, 10th class books, which is life process. This is a chapter number 6 and biology's first chapter, that is called life process, in which we can explore the different aspects of the what is life and how life process does. Okay, what is the different processes which makes life in continuous way? Okay, how can we say that life is end, and how can we say that life is continue in that way, in their way? Okay, in this chapter we will cover their particular different aspects in which we can discuss here. Okay, so the major topics we will cover in this chapter is the very basic chapter about some phenomena which occurs in our body, to maintain the life process, like our nutrition, taking nutrition, mode of nutrition, respiration, excretion, transportation. Okay, so the first topic we will cover in this chapter is what is life. We will first understand what is life and how life works. Okay, the second topic is what is life processes. Okay, why, how life process, how life maintain their in continuous way. Okay, and when we call life is end. Okay, in which condition we call life is end, life is over of a particular organisms. Okay, we will discuss in this topic. And third topic, we will difference process to maintain the life. What is the difference processes to maintain the life? We will also goes in detail with these four processes in this chapter. That is, first process is called nutrition, in which we can also discuss about what is the different mode of nutrition in which plants or animals, what is the mode of nutrition of animals, what is the mode of nutrition of plants. Okay, and second is respiration. What is respiration? When we talk about respiration, that means respiration contains two types of respiration. First is external respiration, which takes place through our external nostril, and second one is called internal respiration, which is when actual site where oxygen exchange with carbon dioxide into the blood, that is called cellular respiration. The respiration takes place on the cell level, that is called cellular respiration. Okay, and transportation means when we take some food in our digestive system breaks down into the small pieces and absorbs some nutrition from them, like protein, carbohydrate, that is called carbs, fat, okay, ions, minerals, vitamins. And these ions, minerals, vitamins, fat, carbohydrate, amino acid, fat, lipid, okay, absorb in the bloodstream and transport through all over the body. Okay, that process is called transportation. Transportation means transfer of nutrient medium from one place to another place of the body. Transportation also takes place in plant also, and transportation takes place in animal also. Okay, and last one is excretion. Okay, excretion means excrete out, remove out some waste material, that is called excretion. When we eat something, this is not necessary that all the eaten part or all the food material we can absorb. Okay, we can digest all the food material, but we cannot absorb all the food material. There is the difference between digestion and absorption. Okay, digestion matlab break down into the small pieces. And what is the absorption? Absorption means absorb that particular nutrient in the bloodstream. That is called absorption. Okay, so is something in the food material always remain unabsorbed? Okay, that is called waste material. that is called feces, which is released by our excretory system. Okay, our urine, when we pass urine is also a waste material. In urine, what waste material we pass? Ammonia. Okay, urea, basically urea in the form of ammonia, in the form of urea. Okay, so excretory system हम पढ़ेंगे, which organ involved in excretory system, which organ involved in transportation, which organ involved in respiration, and which organ involved in nutrition. We will go detail in this chapter. First, we will start here from what is life. Okay, how can you differentiate between life, live or non-life? How can you say that this is life and this is non-living thing? This is living thing, this is non-living thing. There is some measures, there is some measurement on the basis of that we can say that life, this is life, this is not life. Okay, what is that measures? First is reproduction. If some organism reproduce, that means it is in life, in nature. When we talk about this marker, can this marker reproduce? No. That means it does not, we cannot say that this marker is living thing because it cannot be reproduced. Okay. But the living organisms can reproduce, first measure. What is the second measure? They can respire. Respire means they can breathe. Okay, breathe in, breathe out. This marker can breathe in, breathe out? No. Okay, that means this is non-living. And the organism which can breathe in, breathe out, like that we are living. Okay, what is the third measure? Third measure is metabolism. Okay, metabolism means when we eat something, it undergoes our digestive system and metabolism. Metabolism means any chemical reaction in our body, that is called metabolism. And chemical reaction in our body are of two types. Okay, metabolism are of two types. What is that? First is catabolism and second is anabolism. Okay, cata means cut. Aise yaad rakhna, cata means cut, yani ki breakdown. The reaction in which something breaks down, that is called catabolism. If I give example, like glucose molecule. Glucose, what is the formula of glucose? C6H12O6. When it breaks down, it will convert two molecule of pyruvate. That we call pyruvate. This is, I think, some students first time hear this type of terms. We will discuss about what is pyruvate. Two molecules of pyruvate. Pyruvate is three carbon molecule. Okay, so means one glucose molecule break into two pyruvate molecule. That is called catabolic reaction. Means something is breaking down. And what is anabolism? Anabolism means the adding. A4 adding, yani ki something reactants. When we talk about product and reactant, there is product and left side is reactant, right side is product. When one or two reactant make single product, that is called combination, addition. This type of reaction is called anabolism. Okay, then form. We can take also example, then glucose, when glucose formation takes place, that is called anabolic reaction. When glucose breakdown takes place, that is called catabolism. What is that particular term we use? When glucose breakdown into the pyruvate, that is called glycolysis. That is called glycolysis. Or when glucose makes, that is called gluconeogenesis. This is the apart from our book, don't be confused here. I just give some extra information to you. What is this? Okay. So don't be afraid from where I teach. Okay. We come out to point what is living and what is non-living. So I just say that what is the living processes? There is the how can we differentiate living or non-living? That means first point was reproduction, second point was respiration, and third point was metabolism. Okay, metabolism means any chemical reaction in our body that is called metabolism. What is the fourth point? Fourth point is growth. Okay, if some organisms grow, that means we can say it is living organisms. Okay, there is four basic measurements on which we can differentiate what is living and what is not living. If we can differentiate that we are living, okay, because all these four aspects are present in us, okay, then there is one question is arise, how life processes run, how life processes begins, how life process continues, okay, if I grow, that means something is new formation in our body, which takes some extra material used in our body to grow something new tissue, something new muscle, bone, hair, okay, facial muscle, something, okay, means for the formation of new things or growth we require some raw material, and from how raw material we get through the metabolism, because we eat something, we eat food, we drink water, from which nutrients absorb in our body, and that nutrients help in formation of new cells in our body, which makes growth. There is also a point to understand that in anabolic reaction, when we talk about adult being, that means rate of anabolic reaction should be high and rate of catabolic reaction should be low. That means in that condition we can say catabolic reaction is just double to anabolic reaction. That means formation of new thing is high as compared to breaking down. Okay, in that condition organisms will grow, because there is one organism is break down, but two organisms is formed. What is plus? Plus one takes place. That means the organisms will be in benefit, and formation of new things always continue in that process. And in catabolic process, catabolic reaction means breaking down process should be high, and anabolic reaction low, that we can say the catabolism is just double to anabolism, in which particular phase this type of situation occur in older phase. In older people, catabolic reaction is high and anabolic reaction is low. That's why older people degrade day by day, means their muscle degraded, their facial muscle degraded, their bone strength degraded, they get wrinkled in their upper skin. Okay, so we can see what is life, we can make different processes work to maintain the life. And third is different processes to maintain the life. What is that different processes? As we see here, nutrition, respiration, transportation, and excretion. What is the mode of nutrition? If we talk about unicellular, if we talk about multicellular, the mode of nutrition is very different in unicellular or multicellular. Okay, in unicellular organisms, the mode of nutrition, what is unicellular? The all organisms is made up of single cell. And what is example? Amoeba is the example of unicellular. What is their structure of amoeba? Okay, this is called finger like projection, that is called pseudopodia. With the help of this pseudopodia, this amoeba get food material or also help in drinking the water. Okay, the mode of nutrition in that is heterotrophic. There is two types of nutrition, autotrophic and heterotrophic. What is autotrophic? When organisms make their food by itself, that is called autotrophic. What is the example? Plants. Plants make their food by on with the help of sunlight, in the presence of sunlight with the help of chlorophyll, that is called autotrophs. And what is heterotrophs? Heterotrophic organisms depend on autotrophs. Means all animals are heterotrophs which direct or indirectly depend on autotrophs, means plants. That's why plant is called producer in our environment, and we are called consumer because plant produce and we consume that products, their products. That is called heterotrophic in nature. Okay. Let's take autotrophic nutrition in detail. Okay, as we read earlier, that autotrophic nutrition found in all plants. Okay, autotrophic nutrition found in all plants. Basically, plant is a producer. Plant is the producer, and we know that producer means which makes their food by itself. Okay. So in nature, plant does reaction, that is called photosynthesis. Due to the reaction of photosynthesis, plant make their food by the help of sunlight, in the presence of sunlight by the help of chlorophyll. What is that reaction? When we see 6O2 oxygen plus 12 H2O molecule in the presence of sunlight and in chlorophyll, with the help of chlorophyll, it will make one glucose molecule, that is C6H12O6 plus 6H2O molecule plus 6CO2 molecule. 6O2 molecule. There is not O2, there is 6CO2. Okay. This is 6 carbon dioxide molecule, 12 water molecule are the reactant or the photosynthesis in the presence of sunlight. Sunlight in the form of ozone particles rays on the chlorophyll of the plant. Okay, or in chlorophyll, it will make C6H12O6, that is called glucose molecule, and 6H2O molecule and 6 oxygen molecule and plus some energy. Okay. This reaction is called photosynthesis reaction. And it will takes place in autotrophic nutrition in plants also. Okay. Where is chlorophyll are present? Any green part of the plant, it will either leaf or stem, in which if there is green, that means there chlorophyll are present. Basically, chlorophyll, the basic site of chlorophyll is mesophyll cells of the leaf. Okay. Plant, there is some plant which have leaf. Okay. When we cut their section, what we see. Okay. There is the difference, different type of segment. One upper part and lower part, that is called xylem. Lower part is called phloem. What is the role of that xylem and phloem? And this section is called mesophyll cells. Okay. When somebody asks about where the chlorophyll are present, we all say that in mesophyll cell of the leaf. And what is the role of this xylem and phloem? Xylem means gel. For the yaad karne ke liye hum ye trick use kar sakte hain. Xylem means gel. okay? It is help in transportation of water from one place to another place, okay? And xylem is unidirectional, and phloem means phal. Phal means fruit, food, nutrition. Phloem help in transportation of food particles from one side to another side, and phloem is bidirectional.